Hello everyone, be very welcome to this particular webinar that we have prepared for all UNICON members. My name is Marco Serrato and I work at Monterrey Tech in Mexico as Executive Director for the Vice Presidency for Research, Graduate Programs and Executive Education. In this particular webinar, we are interested in sharing our experience on developing corporate universities, which is a key strategy that we have worked on in the last few years as Monterrey Tech and as a university as a whole. To share this particular experience, today is with me Dr. Carlos Villanueva, who is precisely in charge of this particular initiative inside Monterrey Tech.
Hi, my name is Carlos Villanueva. I am in charge of the Corporate Universities Division, and we will have the opportunity in this webinar to share with you not only what Monterrey Tech is doing regarding continuous education and executive education, but also specifically in corporate universities. It is a very interesting model that we have used in several corporations in different countries, and we will have the opportunity to share with you these ideas. We hope these ideas are useful for you.
Thank you so much, Carlos. So, first of all, what we would like to share is some initial thoughts on why is it that we, as a university, and I think that this is a particular question that some of our colleagues, representatives towards different universities at UNICON, have asked ourselves. Why is it that it is worth it? Why would it be worth it to work on a corporate university initiative for us as executive education people and as a university as a whole? Let me just start briefly sharing some little background about Monterrey Tech. Monterrey Tech is a university system that started 70 years ago, founded by a group of entrepreneurs, and nowadays the university has 31 campi located all over Mexico, but also the university has presence in more than 60 countries worldwide through our online programs, which include not only continuing and executive education programs, but also specific graduate programs. Monterrey Tech as a university also has nowadays 23 representation offices worldwide, including North America, Latin America, Europe, and Asia as well. Having said that, we would like to go into the very first question that motivates this discussion. Why is it that it is important for us as Monterrey Tech to work on corporate universities? Basically, what we have defined is that we said some years ago that we had a particular challenge. What is that particular challenge? To develop long-term partnerships with the organizations we work for. What does that mean? We said as part of our vision statement as a university that we were interested in being more than a course and academic programs supplier. We wanted to take advantage of all of our graduate schools, colleges, and departments that may be of interest to all of our customers and the organizations that we work for. But also to promote collaborative work among graduate schools throughout the entire university, and as a final and last step, to be seen as a strong university, easy to work with as a whole. So that was the basic challenge or the motivation that we had. And based on that, we said, well, we consider that we are doing a pretty good job working on executive education programs, not only in Mexico, but in Latin America and in some other parts of the world as well. But we said, well, we want to go further than that. Based on that, what we defined a little more than 5 years ago is to work on in particular on what we defined as a collaboration model that we were interested in developing in between the university and the organizations we work for. In particular, this industry university collaboration model was defined as a partnership continuum. And that is precisely what you can see on this slide. We said, well, if we want to work with these organizations on being more than a program or course supplier, to put it in brief words, we said we need to develop different levels of engagement. And we said, well, we can see that we have 5 different phases or stages to create strategic relationships with these organizations that were defined as awareness, involvement, support, sponsorship, and also to be seen as a strategic partner. As you can see on this particular slide, we identified not only as an executive education department, but as a university as a whole, what is it that we could take towards the organization, things that we are doing inside our graduate programs, executive education programs, continuing education programs, undergraduate programs, in order to take all of these initiatives, also not only in terms of programs, but also in terms of research and development, technology transfer initiatives that we have as a university, and to put all of these elements together to create a pretty interesting value proposition for all of these organizations. And that was organized precisely on these 5 particular stages. If we go a little further into these particular stages, we said, well, we can identify different levels inside these stages that were stated as part of what we define as a university as our collaboration model. This particular collaboration model stated the elements, the activities, the programs, the initiatives that we could develop for these organizations. As you can see on this particular slide, we said, well, we can work on what is identified on the first row to work on the future human capital development, which is basically related to what is it that we are doing nowadays as a university with our undergraduate programs towards the future needs that these universities have, internships, in terms of curriculum development, workshops, seminars, student certification, et cetera, et cetera. Some particular elective courses that were in some sense linked to these needs that the organizations had. But also to work with the current human capital development inside these organizations, which is precisely what we do in executive education, in some of our graduate programs, on the continuing education programs, some tailor-made programs, custom-made programs. And we said we can work on all of these particular stages. And one of those initiatives, as we can see on this second row linked to the last column, we said, well, we can work on particular initiatives under this strategic umbrella, which is to develop or to work with the corporate universities inside these organizations. We also work on some other initiatives on this as a whole in terms of technology transfer, research and development, as you can see that is stated on this particular slide. The main message behind this is the corporate universities initiative is one of the key elements under the umbrella of this strategic vision that we have as a university in terms of what is that we want to put on the table towards all of these organizations that we work for. Having said that, what is some of the learnings and success to date that we have had so far? First of all, I would say that one of the most important things is that we have been able to create not short but long-term partnerships with some of these organizations, with several of these organizations. We work not in developing specific programs, but to work with these organizations to help them accomplish their mission and vision statements, to develop higher levels of engagements and stronger interactions in the development of executive education programs among the organization, and having these executive education programs as part of the corporate university initiatives in some cases. To be able to match the skills required at each position, a strategic position in the organization, in accordance to the programs designed and developed. Also, we have worked in a pretty good level, as Dr. Villanueva will state later, not only developing face-to-face programs, but also hybrid and online programs as well. And as part of the value proposition, to develop and work on LMS, on learning management systems, under which all of these initiatives are supported. So what is, in other words, the value proposition that we put on the table? As I said at the very beginning, to be more than a program or course supplier on specific academic areas for some of these organizations. This value proposition included executive and continuing education programs, but also learning environments design, specific collaboration initiatives, and also in some specific cases, research and development as well as technology transfer initiatives that we put as a wall towards what we can do or support with these particular organizations. Having said that, I would like to ask Dr. Villanueva to share with you what is in particular what we have done in terms of development and management of corporate universities under this particular strategic umbrella or initiative. Carlos.
Thank you. We all know that corporations all over the world are facing change in their settings, and they need to upgrade the skills of the employees that they have to better face these changes that the corporations are facing. Here is when we see the opportunity to have an academic partnership with them. We, as Monterrey Tech, can offer important academic services for the these global corporations that are facing important changes in the market that they serve. Basically, as Dr. Serrato was mentioning, we have 31 campi around Mexico, and we have a strong academic body. We have different academic schools, and we offer these faculty members that can serve the needs of these development programs that these corporations need to develop in order to improve the skills that the people have. And also, as Dr. Serrato mentioned, we have some offices not only in Latin America, but also in other parts of the world, US, Europe, and Asia. So in some times, we can use those facilities to have some face-to-face seminars or events that can enrich the online education that we typically do in the corporate universities. What is the model that we have as a corporate university? What is the model that we use? Typically, we have a very strong coordinated teams between the university and the organization. And we have monthly meetings at very top levels of the organization and the Monterrey Tech. So we are overseeing the strategic activities that we're doing as a corporate university. We see the advances and challenges that we are facing in the project. And also we, in those monthly meetings, we develop specific plans to make sure that all the teams in different areas are advancing as we are planning. We have people in different countries working together with the corporation, making sure that we can assess the training needs that they have. And so we have people that are operating during the month, and so at the end of the month, we have a chance to evaluate what we are doing, what changes need to be done to better serve the corporations that we are doing. It is also interesting to see the operational model that we have. Basically, we have six important elements in this operational model. One of that is the use of a learning management system in which we as Monterrey Tech are prepared to use any learning management system that the corporation is willing to use. So we use different platforms, academic platforms, to make sure that we have all the information for the employees, the courses that they have taken, the skills that they need, the positions that they have. So we integrate different human resources information in order to make sure that we are offering important developing opportunities for the employees in the corporation. Also, we have typically a help desk in which employees that are taking the courses can call us and ask us any questions that they may have. Some typical questions, specifically at the beginning, is some employees have lost the password and cannot have access to the LMS. That's one typical question. But once they are enrolled, sometimes they have specific content questions or any issue with the computer that they are using, that they cannot connect to the platform or they cannot watch a video or something. So we have call center, a help desk where they can call and ask us any question they may have, and we provide an answer typically in less than 24 hours. Also, it is important to know that we have a module of administration, so we are updating the catalog of courses, so we need to have an updated list of courses, the active courses, when they start, when you need to finish the course. If we are going to eliminate a course of the catalog, we let the people know which will be the last time they will have to take that course. So we are also conducting the registration of the employees in each particular course that they are taking. So that's an important element of the model that we have. Also, the content development, it is important because, as we said previously, corporations are changing and they need to develop new skills in the employees. So we have a content development area in which we receive the need of a country, and either with our expert, one academic faculty member, or with an executive from the corporation, we develop the content to be used in that particular LMS that we are using with that corporation. Also, we have a technical office in which this is our quality assurance office, in which we make sure that all the programs, all the courses will be able to run in the computers that the employees in the different countries have, so they won't face any issue with the technology. So we need to test the software, the courses, before we added to the platform. And finally, we use information and learning technologies to make sure that we are developing the skills, not only knowledge, but also skills and abilities in the participants. And this also important to know that these six elements are completely integrated, and we have different people running each of these elements, and we work together to make sure that all of them are going in the same direction as the strategic plan indicates. I would like to share, finally, a success story. It is a finance corporation based in Europe, in which we have been working for them for almost 10 years, and you can see some of the specifics in this slide, but I would like to mention some of the important numbers that we have with them last year. Last year, we had with them nearly 3 million content hours offered to 115 employees in 21 countries in three different languages. As you can see, this is a huge operation, and it is interesting to know that in these years, now we manage 60% of the total training hours of that global corporation based in Europe is managed by Monterrey Tech, and it is our biggest example of corporate universities. Marco, do you have any final remarks or any final comments that you want to make?
I will just add, based on what Carlos just shared, that this particular example with a European finance organization is one of the different cases that we have developed throughout the last years as Monterrey Tech, in terms of, as I said at the very beginning, creating this long-term relationship with an organization. Thinking in terms of the things that we do as executive education representatives from our different universities, I would say that one of the key issues in this initiative is that we are working not only thinking in terms of being an executive education supplier for specific programs. Executive education programs that we deliver are part of a broader initiative, which is this specific collaboration model that we work on towards these organizations. The corporate university initiative is one key element because it has allowed us to create this long-term relationship. And this relationship allows us, as I already said, to create not program-based relationships, but a broader, longer-term relationship. I would also add that for us as a university, it has required some adjustments in our organizational structure. We have been able to put different graduate schools, not only our business school, but different graduate schools, engineering and technology, humanities, just to put a couple of examples, to put them working together and develop solutions programs for these corporate universities that we develop and manage for these specific universities. Having said that, I am aware that this may be a lot of information in quite a short amount of time, so we will be more than glad in answering any particular question or comment that you may have. We will be more than happy in being in touch with any of you. You will see which are our email accounts, not only for me, but also for Carlos, for Dr. Villanueva as well. Please feel free to contact us to let us know any particular question, comment. We have received a lot from the opportunity of participating at UNICON, so if we can be of any help sharing some of our experiences, we will be more than happy to do that. Carlos.
Thank you very much for listening this webinar, and as Marco said, please feel free to contact us if you have any questions. It is my pleasure to answer any request that you may have. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, and have a nice day. Bye.